we look at just two simple sets in this video. Set P, which has 1, 2 and 3 as its elements, and set Q, which has 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 as its elements. Understand the elements well. This has 1, 2 and 3, and this one has 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is a part of this, and that's why we say set P is a part of set Q. And we learnt in the previous video that part of also means subset. So we can say that set P is a subset of set Q. Do we have a symbol to represent this? Yes, it's written like this. P is a subset of Q. The letter U is sleeping on this line. So when is P a subset of Q? Set P is a subset of set Q when every element in P is also present in Q. Look at the elements. Every element in P is also present in Q. But this statement raises a new query. Look at sets C and D. Set C has 4, 5 and 6 as its elements, and set D has 4, 6 and 5 as its elements. Both the sets have the same elements, which makes them equal. But every element in set C is also present in set D. Based on the definition, we can say that set C is a subset of set D. This also tells us something more. It tells us that every set is a subset of itself. P is a subset of P, Q is a subset of Q, and so on. For some reason, this does not seem entirely correct, and that gave rise to a new concept of proper subset. Look at sets P and Q. Set P is a part of set Q, but there is at least one element in set Q which is not present in set P. We say that set P is a proper subset of set Q. This sign indicates proper subset. And this tells us that all elements of P are present in set Q, but there is at least one element in Q which is not present in P. We can see that 4 and 5 are not present in P. So that's the concept of a proper subset. Sometimes it is also referred to as the strict subset. Can we say C is a proper subset of D? Think about it. That would be incorrect since there is no element in D which is not a part of C. There has to be at least one such element. That's the only difference between a subset and a proper subset. Just one last thing we need to understand. Just as we say P is a proper subset of Q, we can also say that set Q is a superset of set P. This symbol is used to represent superset.